ik ben helemaal gelukkig. Ja, ja, dat is niet goed. Ja, maar ik ben niet aan het doen, maar ik zou al niet nog meer gelukkig. Maar ook voor de partij natuur. Ja, in de zorg om het te doen. Maar dat is mijn net van nou. Ja, maar ik ben niet aan het doen. Als het aan het doen. Als het voor het van nou. Maar ik zit er naar toe. Ik zou het van niet weer. Ik moet het wel al winnen. Ja, om de naamwa op me de massa. Ja, wat ben nou die hele toon van mijn kinderen. Ja, ik ben jou de massa geld. Ja, en daar hoor ik maar nog een leef van af. Die mee het er nog een leef van zo geld. Toen moet dat dan voor iemand. So I think it is very appropriate and useful for your children to know and to be informed of what we are talking about, especially when I share the message, so that they can follow along. And sometimes we use big words, but for the kids, we just want to play, lay it out plain and simple, and make it easy for them to understand. So for the children, I also talk in English because I know some of you will not understand when I talk in Sanborn, but I hope you keep learning your Sanborn. It's good. Good to learn two languages when you grow up. It's, you know, you feel proud. You feel a lot of assurance in your identity as Sanborn. And so anyway, today's two stories, one from the Old Testament, and that is about people going really grumpy and complaining because they did not have water. You know, when you are thirsty, you really are restless. So that's what happened when the Israelites were on their journey. They felt very thirsty, but there was no water. So they start picking fights with Moses and his brother Aaron. Why you bring us out? Why you leave us there? Why don't you leave us there in Egypt, where there's a lot of water? You need a lot of food. So anyway, some people were really aggressive. Really trying to give Moses some trouble. So Moses and Aaron went and talked to God. And God said, all right, take some men and go to the rock where I will show you. And then you hit the rock with your rod. You know that rod? That's the one he waved and the sea parted. You know, that's the same rock. So take that rock and whack the rock with it and the water will come out. And he did. So, in line of what I will be sharing today, that's what happened when God gave Moses the authority to do things, to do lots of things, and even gave him the authority to make water come out of the rock. But then we don't see the story, but later on, Moses is told to do the same. But not this time, not striking with the rod, but speak to it. Speak to it and water will come out. But what did he do? What did he do? He didn't listen. What did he do? He didn't speak. Not just once, he whacked the rock twice. Didn't listen to God. And if you read the story, Moses didn't reach the promised land. And it's based on that story. Not obeying God, telling him to speak to the rock. And that's why he didn't reach the promised land. Because the writer said that God was ashamed. He was supposed to speak to the rock so that water can come out, but he was so angry. And he forgot that he was supposed to speak, so he banged the rock once, twice. Water did come out, but he disobeyed God. So sometimes the authority that is given to us, it comes with rules. You know, if your parent tells you, no, you do this, you do that, but remember, do this. Yeah. So it's not all freedom. You have to remember what your parents or what the teacher tells you, so that you can reach the promised land, you can reach the end, you can have the blessings. The New Testament stories is about Jesus teaching in the temple. You can see him teaching with disciples and some other people. And the people standing in the back, supposed to be the leaders of the people. So leaders were Pharisees, Sadducees, priests. They were leaders. So some of them are all there in the background, standing up. They came and listened to him, and his teaching didn't sound really familiar to them. And some of the things he did before that, which I'll be talking about in my sermon, they were saying, whose authority? Who gave you the authority to do these things? So these things I will be talking about, but the question is, what authority and whose authority? So that's the picture there. And the funniest part is Jesus said, if you want some mind question, I will tell you what authority and whose authority. So he says, you know the story of John the Baptist? No? Yes? He went around baptizing people. And leaders of the people didn't like him too. So Jesus said to them, well, I'm asking you a question. If you answer me, then I will answer you. So whose authority did John get his work from, place his work on? So I said, well, if you tell me whose authority, who gave John the authority, I will also give you an answer. And they really smart people, they don't want to be wrong. They talk to each other. Oh, if we say authority from God, then he was going to ask them, why didn't you believe him? Why didn't you follow him? Why didn't you do the things that he said? But if we say to him, oh, his authority is from some people, then the people are going to really hate us. Because they believe that John's authority was from God. So they say, I don't know. So did Jesus tell them? Well, he said, if you tell me the answer, I will tell you the answer to your question. They didn't. So he didn't. But in my sermon, I think he did. He says he didn't, but he did. He's a very smart man. Not straightforward answer, but in the way he answered their question. So that is the sharing and the message. I will be telling the big children, us. So I hope you can follow along.